Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to go over my Season 6 wish list for Apex Legends. Things that I would like to see added or changed, and we're going to take it a step further, and we're going to look at what other content creators are thinking, and we're going to talk about what some of you guys are thinking. So, before we get started though, I want to add this little disclaimer, because there's always a handful of people that take things the wrong way, okay? I love Apex Legends. I would go as far to say that this is my favorite game of all time, but even though it's my favorite game, there's always room for improvement. There's always something that can make it even better and more enjoyable to play. And that's what this conversation is about. There's things that we would like to see added or changed, and not just myself, but you guys as well, that would make the experience even better than it is, okay? Always room for improvement. So don't take it the wrong way. I'm not knocking the game at all. I absolutely love it. It's just a good conversation to have, especially because the developers are always listening. They're all ears, man. They hear you guys. And the best way to get your ideas heard is to have a discussion about it, right? You want to be civil, you want to be polite, and you want to have a discussion about it, and that's what this is. So before we get started, I want you guys to comment down below. Before you hear anything that we talk about in this video, comment something down below that you would like to see changed or added into Apex Legends. You want to do it before the video starts, just because it's going to be your idea completely. You're not going to be influenced by what you hear in the video. It's going to be all you. Be polite about it, because the developers are listening. And that brings me onto this point. So, the idea of this video came because I made a tweet a few weeks ago now, where I asked everybody, what would you like to see added into Apex Legends? And then I gave an example with Revenant, okay? That was just an example. And it gained a lot of traction. A lot of content creators commented on it, a lot of you guys commented on it, and then one of the developers actually replied to it as well. So, that just doubles down on what I said earlier. They're listening. So if you want your voice heard, be polite about it and they'll hear you, man. So I'm gonna start things off with a few things that I would like to see added. First and foremost, I feel like we should never be without an LTM. Never be without an LTM. You know, we've had so many different ones added. LTM, by the way, is limited time mode. It was like all the holiday events, like with the train, the Shadowfall mode that is, armed and dangerous, the gold mode where it was all gold guns only, stuff like that. We should never be without an LTM. I feel like they should be able to recycle and use those LTMs all over again and just rotate them weekly. You know, every single other game has LTMs. And right now we only have ranked and pubs. That's what we have. We have ranked and pubs. And I just think that we should always have an LTM in rotation just for something new. Because, it gets tiring playing the exact same thing over and over and over. And sometimes you just want to chill out and, you want to be in shadow form and just play an LTM, I don't think I'm out of line for thinking that way. So that's number one. Number two, the way they release content is good and bad. So every single time we get a new season, we get a massive update. Map changes, legends, weapons, town takeovers, we get a bunch of stuff early on in the season. But the problem comes at the second half of the season, which is where we're at right now, where things just feel so stale because nothing gets added for what feels like 2 months, really, give or take. So we're playing the same game for a couple months straight with no real changes, and it just gets really, really hard to continue playing and grinding that same game, because again, it's just 2 months really of the same thing, and it just makes it difficult. So flip-flop in the meta, sprinkle in some LTMs, the LTM thing at the beginning, that would help this too, just sprinkle in some LTMs. I think that would be a big deal. So kind of flip-flop in the way they drop the content on us would be kind of nice. Now, the next big one that I want to talk about goes hand in hand with the other two. It's kind of like a package combo. The three of these, they really work together. And it's a big one, man. It's a big one. It's meta changes. We need to see more legend changes, more weapon changes, more frequently. Think about it. Every single time we see a legend or a weapon change and something else becomes meta, it's meta for like 3-4 months at a time. It's really, really, really long. It's way too long. And you kind of seen the same thing happen with Overwatch, where you would see these meta changes and that meta would be that meta for months at a time. It's too long. It's way too long. You need to add more changes to keep things fresh and you switch it up, right? Because like, especially when people start getting good at the game, they're just going to keep running the meta. You're going to see the same weapons every single game and nothing else can compete. So I would like to see more variety in the game. So that's a big one, especially for guys like me. As a content creator, I like to try to use different weapons. I was doing those challenge videos where I tried to use one weapon at a time and I just kind of abruptly stopped. And the reason that I stopped was because it just wasn't possible to do on a regular basis. You know, it sucks because with skill-based matchmaking, you see these really good players running the meta weapons, which they should, you know, they're running the meta. And I'm trying to compete using a non-meta weapon, and it's just, you can't, man. You can't do it. You have to do the meta. So at least if there were flip-flopping things around, it would keep it fresh, and there'd be more variety in the game, and it would just feel good to play, you know? So those are my three big ones, and now I want to kind of go over the tweet that I made and look at some of the suggestions that other content creators made and some of you guys made. First up, Staycation says, to be honest, there's certain metas that will always be annoying, but nothing annoys me more than the unfair opportunity to even contest. I still think that we should spawn with Gray Shields and a P2020 or a Mozambique. Limit them as floor loot. They are literally useless, which makes a lot of sense. If you think about it, you take the P2020 and the Mozambique off the floor completely. You take Gray Armors off the floor completely. You're going to find way more better gear. You're going to find upgrades to your gear, and you're going to start with the basics, right? So you have a better loot pool, and you have a start at the beginning of a game. You're not reliant on RNG. So I really like this change. This is really good to hear, and it's nice to see that other people are kind of thinking the same thing. Deltouche said, I didn't come up with this, but I would like to see the firing range accessible while in queue for a game. It would make time fly. I think this applies more so to PC. I know most of you guys probably play on console, seeing as I'm a console guy myself, but if you do play on PC, then queue times are extremely long, especially if you're playing in like a Predator lobby or even a Diamond lobby. Queue times are really, really long. So, you know, while you're in queue, it would be really sweet to be able to just hop in the range, you know, keep warm and keep playing the game. So I agree with that. I think that would be really cool. Lots of other games have done that. Overwatch started doing that. And I think another thing to kind of add on to that, I think would be really cool, is if they added like a play again feature, where if you're in a game and you win or lose, you can just hop right into the next game without going right back to the lobby. I think that would be a good touch to have too. So, you know, kind of goes hand in hand, I guess. Next up, we got Zeus, who says, the ability to strafe while looting on controller. I don't care if it's even an auto strafe, just anything that will make it so I don't get beamed while looting. If you guys don't know this, if you're a console player, PC players can move while they loot. They can move with their keyboard, so their character is moving while they're looting. And it's huge, right? Because like, if you're sitting there looting, you're just a sit and duck. You can get fried real quick. So on PC, at least you're able to crouch and move around while you're looting. Makes it harder to die, really. So good idea. I like that one a lot. Next up, we got Father Finicus himself. I would like for the shots not to be as loud. I think it would minimize the third partying, not the actual noise coming out of your gun, but what you can hear from across the map, which makes sense. If you think about it, how far can you hear shots? Really, really, really far. If they lowered the sound of gunshots that you hear, the distance of it at least, then third partying would go down like crazy. You would see way less third partying, and I just think it would be more fun. I agree with that one 110%. I heard a lot of other people talking about that one too. I heard Nicewig mention that, a bunch of others. So I like that one a lot. Good idea, Finn. Next up is the Craver Queen herself, Lulu. She says that she would like to see an actual streamer mode, and I vouch 1,000,000% on that as a content creator. That is so necessary. It sucks trying to talk about it because you kind of get the ninja treatment, right? Like back when Ninja was talking about stream snipers, you get a lot of backlash for it, but it genuinely is a big problem, especially in Apex, man. You see the name in the kill feed, that's all it takes. Or you see the champion squad, that's all it takes, and people will play completely differently. If you follow me on Twitter, I've been a big advocate for that, and luckily we have heard that there is a streamer mode coming, so that's really good to hear. We don't know when or anything like that, but it is going to be a thing. But big problem, and I'm glad to hear that other people feel the same way that I feel about it, because oh my god, it frustrates me so much. It really does. Now we've got Spooky here, the rare crypto main. Not many of those guys around. He says that the crypto EMP should destroy active caustic traps. And I would love to see this happen. I think you would see way more cryptos in-game. There's not very many crypto mains out there, man. So he's a good character. He's really, really cool. But when you're playing caustic and you see an EMP coming, all you need to do is shoot your traps. It doesn't get rid of active traps. So big change. I think that would be a great idea. It would change the meta completely. I think it would be awesome to see. This next one is a great idea, and I actually talked about this one in one of my previous videos a few weeks ago already. Gravy says they should add a game mode sort of like how Destiny did for raids, but in Apex. Imagine having a raid in Apex that involves all the different legends in the game. It would be super fun. Also, a solo game mode. I think this would be incredible, and I don't think it's completely out of the realm of possibility, considering that we had those quests. And the quests were so much fun. If you guys didn't play the quests or know the story or the lore behind Apex Legends, you're missing out, man. The story and the lore with Apex is so cool. I absolutely love that they did that. If there's no other BR that is implementing a story quite how deep, you know, Apex Legends is. And you're learning about the past while also evolving the future. It's a really cool story, and I think adding these PvE elements into the game would be absolutely incredible. And I think it would be good for the solo player as well, right? Like, there is no solo mode, and the developers already said there is no solo mode coming. I mean, maybe as an LTM, they might add it every now and then just to have it. I don't know, but, you know, there's going to be no solo mode. But if there was a PvE mode of some sort, I think that would be incredible. Great idea. I would love to see that. Okay, so that tweet ended up getting like 1,000 replies to it. It was absolutely insane how many people replied to it. And I can't go over everything, but what we're going to do now is we're going to give just a quick thunder round. We're going to go through a bunch of tweets in rapid succession, so don't blink because we're going to go through it real quick. Shelby says we should be able to destroy your Pathfinder zipline after you launch it, kind of how Loba can turn off her black market. Strapalicious says you should be able to double tap Crypto's Tactical, toss his drone up in the sky, and it could follow you around and makes for easier EMPs. A small change would be adding emotes from Mr. Random. Rifki says make legend tokens more useful. I would love to see that, by the way. Leon says not really a change, but different revive animations for different characters like Watson and Gibby when they're in the bubble. Danny says it would be nice that you could have Crypto's drone have a follow mode where it just kind of circles above you and follows you around. Jacob would like to be able to ping what percentage your ultimate is at. Tierkey says the ability to go back and watch your games like a theater mode or a replay mode. That's genius, by the way. Eterna TK says the Sentinel should have the ability to penetrate through Lifeline and Gibraltar's bubbles when charged. Mate Buddha says, a friend of mine, you should be able to ping what weapons you're looking for. Like, if you pick up a hop-up, you should be able to ping what weapon that hop-up is for. Banksy says that your caustic gas should be more identifiable if it's friendly caustic. Like, there's tons of stuff like this. There is a million different things that we could go over. The tweet, like I said, it has like 1,000 replies. If you want to scroll through it yourself, my Twitter is in the description. Click on that and you can find the tweet. It's towards the top. I don't really tweet that often, so it's not hard to find. But scroll through it, man. There's some genius, genius replies in there. Some really good changes that I would like to see. And now I want to show you the reply that I got from Josh Medina, who is a developer over at Respawn. He said, great thread, lots of ideas here for the team to think about. Hell, some of which we might even be working on, which is really good to hear. Okay, so the fact that he even scrolled through that tweet, which again had a stupid amount of replies, there was so many people that were replying to it, it was insane. He scrolled through it and he read it, and this is what he had for us. Obviously, he can't tell us what he's working on. He can't be like, oh, we're gonna do this and that and this and that. He can't have that, obviously, right? But the fact that he's there and listening just shows that their ears are open. So that's why this video, I think, is important, because if you want to comment down below, the developers are going to go through it. They're going to. They read this stuff. They love this stuff, right? This is their game that they've built, and it's an incredible game, and they want to do nothing but make it better. So again, like I said at the beginning, comment something down below. If you haven't already, I encourage you to do so, because your voice will be heard. Now, I know this video is something different than I would normally upload. If you're a longtime viewer, you're probably used to the gameplay stuff that I would upload. But, you know, I feel like something like this is important, and lots of people have concerns. Lots of people have opinions on things, and they want their voice to be heard, right? And it's hard to find an avenue to voice your concerns. So I thought that maybe this would be a good idea to put out there. So again, if you have anything that you want to add, leave it down below. Make sure you keep it polite, keep it civil, because again, these are human beings that you're talking to. They love this game. The developers love this game. They want to do nothing but improve it and make it better for themselves and for you guys, right? Like, that's all they really want to do. So, you know, don't be a dinkhead down below. Don't be a dinkhead to people. Be calm, be polite, and your voice will be heard, I promise. But yeah, thank you guys so very much for watching. I hope you were at least entertained. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you on the next video.